discuss a little bit what we have heard in this session. Now that we have pressed all that input and open our appetite before the last break. So, I would like to call Mrs. Tomsko, Director of the Department for European Digital Agenda of ICT for Albania. Please come. My pleasure. Thank you. So, Mrs. Kusrin Sala, Marketing Product Manager from Vodafone. Mr. Yes. And Mrs. Ferry, CEO from, I should have him, have a seat please, from MPay. Mr. Igor Bimbilovsky, Head of Strategy and Business Development from AMETSE. And finally, Mr. Sara, General Director of Infosoft. And Mr. Gitan Mezini, Board Chairman of Albanian Information Technology Association. Thank you. I say thank you. So having all that in mind, it seems that a lot of things are happening in the cloud computing era in Albania, and I would like, without any further delay, to start with Filma and to explain us a little bit which are your plans, your organization plans to facilitate more the development of cloud computing concept in Albania.
Services through the mobile phone. And this is one of the reasons that since the beginning, we have had, we have made a strong discussion with the financial institution, like banks, like central banks, like the mobile provider services. And let's say that we have succeeded a bit because there are, let's say, in this moment, three models of the mobile payments in the market, but they need to be more marketized, let's say. So the public has to know much more about that. Why? Looking to the market and looking to the different researches made in the payment market, we saw that there are a lot of people unbanked. So let's say in the rural zones, there are people that have no connection with the bank. And they are obliged to make some payments for the electricity, for the water, for other services, for their products, etc. So the mobile applications installed in this location, usage of the mobile services and different models will be necessary to attract these people, these citizens, to the platforms. The next, and not less important, is that now and then the people are too much busy in the everyday work, so they have no physical time to reach the financial institution. So these platforms, like mobile platform, like e-portals, I promote also with the law, the e-portal of government gateway, Ludanian portal. There are over, my colleague said before, around 80 services, informational and real services. So people, citizens now can receive their birth certificate from this portal. They can receive a lot of other tax information, the insurance, how, what their, let's say, company pays for that, for the health, etc. They can see directly in this portal. And in the near future, they can make also payment with this portal. So, entering also the security elements, all this make this platform and this system more affordable and more secure.
Having no agreement about that, you have a very difficult job. But I understand that you know your subject, and I have only to tell you that don't lose your faith, I mean your individual faith. You're going to need time and funds, of course.
Yes.
But I believe that at the very end, you're going to succeed a lot.
First, it has to put some trees, we have to put the market, and we have to create the synergy between the private, between the academia, with the business, to work together with the government to achieve our
targets. Thank you very much. I would like to take the opportunity to ask my colleague Kushri, that it seems that broadband internet comes to Albania from many issues, but mainly from mobile internet, and there are a lot of expectations from telcos to develop further the connectivity issue, and develop at the same time the local IT industry to be developed somehow. Do you believe there are options in that area? I know that since recently you have launched a new product related to mobile payments. You want to elaborate a little bit more?
Yes, thanks. It is true that telecom companies are improving and are increasing their services and are becoming more and more ICT providers, not just the communication providers. The prevalence of and payment and electronic payments in Albania, to be honest, is in the modest, remains still modest. The thinking behind of this newly product that Vodafone Albania has introduced, M-Pesa, is to combine, to offer a combination of the telecommunication services, communication services, hosted services, and the payment, which I think that Vodafone Albania and things that will contribute very much on this let's say penetration of the mm-hmm. of the customers that are willing to buy through the internet and through the mobile, let's say. I would say that M-Pesa is the world's most successful money transfer. It is not, for the moment, mobile payment. It is the money transfer, I would say. The customers can pay only the Vodafone services through M-Pesa. For this moment, Vodafone M-Pesa is offering just transferring money from peer-to-peer, from a customer to customer. So, every Vodafone customer can visit the authorized shop or the authorized agent, and they can register and they can transfer their money without having the necessary need to have a bank account, which is a very let's say an easy way to offer this kind of services. And if, on the other hand, the recipient will be very easy to receive this money and to redeem them on the real cash or just to use them for another service from Vodafone.
Thank you very much. So it seems that Mrs. Story, there are a lot to be done in mobile payments, huh? What kind of mobile payments do you believe that we could deliver more to the money market?
Well, I would be totally biased in answering that question because I would say the one we offer, but we are very realistic and we know that we cannot fulfill all the needs of the market. One point, Kusim said that offering mobile payments through bank accounts is the easy way to offer it. I would like to attest to the contrary. It has taken us ages to set up the service, and M-Pay holds the status of a startup for the past 5 years. So by industry definitions, would have been dead by now. But by some chance of luck, we are still around, and we seem to be doing quite well. In fact, I was going to raise your point, but it would have been my last, but since you turned that around for me, I will state it now. Certainly, the mobile payment is on the course of liberalization with, like Vilma mentioned, three models already on the market, M-Pesa only having been invited to this ecosystem last week. But there are another mobile payment platform was launched and thrown around here for discussion today, and that's the platform through Posta Shitara. I would like to pause for 5 seconds on that one because I'm sorry that the representative of USAID is not here, but the assumptions on which this mobile payment platform is based on are the wrong ones. We have had many chances and many opportunities to discuss and to raise these issues with them, and I have personally asked them one question, because there seems to be a lot of talk about how financial inclusion, like banks and new financial institutions cannot reach the whole population, like M-Pesa caters to an unbanked population and it's here. So why introduce another one? And no one seems to be able to answer the question as to where this technology is really not doing it for us today. as to where is this other need to address, which is not already addressed by existing mobile money solutions, banking services, etc. So I would like for an impartial institution like USAID or whoever else can invite themselves to the table to be able to address and answer that question.
We will take that for the third session.
Okay.
Could you please sum up the three top benefits for mobile payments for citizens or business?
Well, it's very difficult to sum up only three, because it depends on the angle and on the point of view. The perspective of a consumer would be easy access to financial services, not wasting more time to pay their bills or to transfer money. For the government, it would be fighting the formal economy. For the banks, mobile operators, or whoever is behind these type of products, who would be appearing more innovative, holding on to their client base and increased loyalty, etc. But if I can, because this is the nice part, but the nice part is never interesting. It's the hard part that is always interesting to discuss and debate. The problem that we have in Albania with pretty much everything, but we are talking about mobile payments right now, is that e-payments or mobile payments are not just a label. Like, it's not something that is cool to have. So be it for banks or for the government, for the country, for the people. So I have mobile payments so I can check it off my list. No, mobile payments are a full ecosystem that has to be developed much in the way that telecommunications, banking, other industries have been developed in the country. Because it's the way forward and it's where the future of technology and financial services is leading us to. And the second one, I will quote Blair at the risk of sounding popular given the recent labor results, is education, education, education. Everyone seems to be coming back to this topic, but no one is saying who should do it. Because we are all biased. Like, if I start communicating in the market about mobile payments, they will say, oh, you are trying to promote your own service. So it must be an impartial party that has to start pushing and channeling the people towards mobile payment. And at the time being, we still seem to be throwing the ball around the pitch without knowing who is going to do that. And the third, but by no means the least problematic of all, is the lack of horizontal collaboration. In Albania, we have a lot of vertical collaboration, but no horizontal collaboration. Players of the same field rarely seem to find a common denominator. We are willing to change that. We have extended, I believe there's been a mutual invitation of collaboration with M-Pesa and other institutions in the market. So we are willing to change that, and we are going to change that, but it's a very, very long process. Thank you. Sorry.
Let's take your time. In that ecosystem that Mrs. Perry mentioned, what do you believe is the role of telco and apparently of MSF?
Yes, so according to the discussion.
Just to be clarify, my question is both to e-payment, or mobile payments, but also for the ecosystem of cloud computing and for the role of telcos to further develop the industry, even the local IT.
So according to the discussion, at least on the payment side, two clear directions. One direction is that the telco and the financial industry is converged one to another. And it's not a doubt that in some time there will be more and more connecting points between two industries, meaning banks, financial institutions one side, and the telecom industry and IT on the other side. The question is, what kind of model is the most appropriate one? This is now the key question. And what the timing need to be the telco industry involved in this term. From our side, we can say that science is a part of Deutsche Telekom. We are always considering this, let's say, topic. But the question is this the topic on the priority list of the telco operators? Why? Because it's very simple. Business model needs to be profitable. Need to bring the value for the one who is playing the game. And as we know until now, most of the business models are not profitable still for the telco industry. That's why when we're going to jump in this game, we're going to jump with a profitable model which will be sustainable on the long term. So there are two questions once again, when and which business model. On the other side, when we are talking about the cloud, it's clear that now Deutsche Telekom, as a leading European operator, has a clear strategy not only on the cloud service, but in general on the integrated European network and platform. Mm-hmm. we as a group and ANT as a part of that group has a clear strategy for the technology leadership, including cloud services, which will be pan-European and centralized one. So each country, including Albania and Amazon, will be part of this production model, so new production model. And on that part, I think that we have a program. It's a program of the Deutsche Telekom Group. We are part of that one. And I think that this will be one of the most efficient models for the cloud services on the European level. It was announced a few months ago in Barcelona by the top management of Deutsche Telekom, and we're going to follow this one, and we count that this production model will be adapted to the local circumstances of Albanian market. It doesn't mean that all the business circumstances are equal everywhere in Europe, but for this market, it's our role to implement it, to use it, and to promote the best one who is fitting to the customer needs. And I think for this plan, we will come very soon with some kind of a proposal to the market.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Enzo, for your statement. You know, I can't resist to... I'm eager to know, if you want the readiness of ICT local industry to respond to the current needs from in government to public sector, but also to take advantage to exploit the cloud computing concept worldwide. Do you have a comment on that as an interpreter? That's why I'm asking you directly.
Well, to speak on behalf of all Albanian IT companies, it's a bit difficult. It's very ambitious, but that could bring, let's say, our experience abroad and perhaps give some recommendation to whatever is which like to invest in the cloud concept. We have been thinking seriously about cloud 3-4 years ago. And for us, it was a clear message either from our partners, our vendors, and our customers that there are three main roles in the cloud area. The first one is to be a cloud builder, the second one is to be a cloud provider, cloud service provider, and the third one is to be simply a cloud itself. And I'm not going to discuss the third option. So 4 years ago, we really decided to invest a lot in the company to have the in-house capacities in terms of human resources, to be a cloud builder in such a way to serve to our customers, and when I say customers, I mean enterprise-class customers, like telcos, banking, and definitely government, to support them with whatever services and products that they might need to build their own clouds. We have been quite successful in the government. Just a couple of words, what do we mean by cloud builder? Our concept of cloud builder means that we have the capabilities starting from to build applications on cloud, to be able to integrate in cloud many services, integrating applications, integrating through a middleware layer. And this is what we exactly did for the Albanian government, along with definitely our partners like Microsoft, HP, and Cisco. In that context, we were able for a couple of years to build different cloud concepts in there, starting from infrastructure as a service, for purely infrastructure services like email, Active Directory, certain identity management solutions, but also providing platform as a service, starting from SQL databases, open source databases like MySQL, but also platforms like SharePoint. Whereas in terms of applications, for example, we built a solution which is called Electronic Records and Document Management System, which is an application as a service solution for government entities. Similar things we are doing also for either other, let's say, private companies like telcos and banking to provide integration services for different platforms so they will be able to provide application and services like that. We believe that the decision we took was quite important and definitely, let's say, profitable in this new cloud area, and we are continuously looking for partners and solutions so we can jointly bring and create new services and new applications for customers. And when I mean customers now, it's not only enterprise class customers, but also consumers. But being engaged on a government, e-government framework, actually, we are now, for example, thinking on how to bring together new mobile applications, for example, for taxpayers, individuals or businesses, but connecting and integrating those also with payment systems.
So the slogan of the conference, Time for Business, you believe it's a good one?
For us, yes.
Yeah. And for the time.
And, I mean, it should have interest from all parties. I think all players are here. Telcos with their connectivity, but also their cloud offerings, companies which are providing mobile payments, and definitely government, which is a champion in that respect, in opinion. Opinion is a very small market, and definitely government is the biggest, most important role.
Okay, okay, thank you very much for your statement. I'd like to check if Mr. Manzini has the same opinion. The thing is that we are used from the representative of an association to take the floor and right away start with complaints about that we don't have enough support, enough funding and things like that. But I would like your experience, from your experience, to have your point of view regarding the readiness of local IT market to take advantage of cloud computing, and if you have any view regarding if there are new engineers, that new entrepreneurs that they can start now, like a startup company and things like that, and proceed in the environment of cloud computing and raise money like a little gigabyte.
Since I'm the last one, I think that is most difficult, I would say, even. Or I can do a recap, you know, pretty much what is the ecosystem in Albania based on the association viewpoint. I'll organize my answer in those aspects. First, I'll be focused on the members of our association. As you know, there are around 72 members. And the capability of our members, as even Mr. Shara mentioned, and even others in the panel, and we heard all around, is that our members are capable of providing the infrastructure, either a platform or the applications for the cloud computing market. So there are capabilities, there are skills that at least we can provide to the needs of the market. But what happens on the other hand is that SMEs or the overall ecosystem doesn't somehow get the best out of this capability. And so they are very resistant to, I'm focused more on SMEs. I know that some of the large corporations already they are embracing the cloud computing, either private or public. But at the SME level, I think that there is still a resistance on embracing the cloud computing, even though the cloud computing is you know, it's a very sexy way of saying the data somewhere in the internet. The internet is very common, and when you say cloud, people somehow they get resistant. And I'll say that one of the main reasons is that in Albania, the market is still not mature enough, you know, to generate or to drive the demand for cloud computing services as an overall. And on the other hand, you know, even if we do brief a little bit the country, if we discuss at country level, it's a small market. It is a small country. It is in the process of development when it comes to using the newest IT trends here in this market. And there are so many things that needs to be done in order to increase the readiness of the country, and then the readiness of SMEs or ICT companies or consumers and all other stakeholders in the market. I think that when it comes to the cloud computing, we have to make sure that there are some pre-homework or some homework done in advance, and like a series of laws about privacy, about the data center risks, about the copyrights and whatsoever. And I think that there are some indicators that need to be fulfilled before we get into this path. On the other hand, like it is for mobile, like it is for software service, that is for e-government, we should even have some kind of e-cloud or cloud computing strategy, because cloud computing has some strong impact to the SMEs, but to overall society in general, even the way that they have to perform the work or they do the work, because they're going to do the work without just with a small interface, with some computers or servers and some applications that they cannot see. They are somewhere in the cloud. And this is a very strong concept to absorb and to use it. So in this context, I'll say that we need to work, but we need to work in cloud computing, we need to work in mobile, we need to work in so many areas in order to build a very happy environment that we can support those plans in the future. As association, we are, I think that always based on our members, I think that we are trying to drive those needs even at the SME level, and we are continuously working, and we believe that education, I think that Bora mentioned education, maturity, promotion, making them clear and simple to all of them, you know, these are some of the ways of solution. Now at least in Albania, at least in the last years, has started the process of startups, incubators, you know, and we see that the majority of the youngsters, they still don't present or promote the concept of cloud computing their solutions. And I think that even at the education level, it is a lot to be done, even at curricular level. I'm saying it is complex ecosystem. We are on the right track, but still a long way to go.
Yeah.
So you see, I didn't complain much.
Yeah, you didn't. Yeah. In fact, I would like to conclude that session now, telling that I'm optimistic that there are people here in Albania that they are not in the cloud, they are working tough here in Earth, and they realize the difficulties and at the same time the opportunities to proceed. So thank you very much for your class and for your time. It was my pleasure to meet all of you, and I hope to have a talk soon. Thank you very much for your time.